Okay, today we're going to try and wrap up this wiring harness, and I'm going to backpedal just a little bit and make sure you understand if you're just now joining. This is the PCM connector, so here's where the computer is. The computer uses all of these wires to communicate out through the harness to communicate to all the sensors and connectors on the engine itself. Beyond that, external to that communication, you're going to need two different areas. I've divided mine up into two areas. One is power. This whole leg up here represents all the power, providing power to this harness, providing power to all the sensors and stuff on the engine. So we're going to wire up the connector for that, as well as in addition to those wires, I've got another section here. This is all communications to things like gauges, such as your OBD2 connector to your tach, and let me think of one more. Your check engine light is a good example. And so what I think we're going to do, first of all, is let's focus. I've got a drawing that I put together, and this will be available. You can download this. It's a PDF file. In the description below this video is will be a copy of this. So let's start by tackling this communication side first. It'll be very easy. We're going to cut these all off the same length and install a connector. I know a lot of people are basically just extending these wires really long and they're going to run them later, that type of stuff. I'm actually going to put a waterproof connector that I purchased. Here's a kit. It's actually got two different ones. These are 8-position connectors. I'm going to install one of these here, and then later on I'm going to run my check engine light in the vehicle and run the wires back and then make that final connection there. And I've got not only this diagram of this side of it, but I've also got what the other side of this connector looks like. Here's the OBD2 connector, oil pressure gauge, the tach, the cooling fan relay, as well as the check engine light. So this is exactly how those wires will be later. Once they're attached to the car, vehicle can run back. This is how I'll connect them, attach them to this connector so they can be plugged into this. I thought it'd be better just to make a connection and not try to rerun a bunch of long wires. So, well, again, we're going to start right here, and let me get set up, and we're going to start getting these cut off. See what that longest one is? The shortest one? Let's cut them all off that length.
Right there?
Yep. Okay, so I've decided we're going to put the female type connector here, and the male will be the other side. So we pulled out 8 different female connectors with the little grommets, waterproof grommets, as well as had to kind of figure out between the female and the male part, kind of which of the locks. This lock goes with the female side, and there's the gasket that's going to go down in there as well when we near the end. So it took a little while to kind of figure out what went where, but we got it all. I think we do have it figured out. So we're going to start off by, let's go ahead and take, let's do this black wire first. We're going to trim this off and get a connector put on there. And before you trim it off, I think it's wise that we go ahead and pre-load that. Okay. Now we're going to need There is a special tool for this, and I just don't feel like buying it for the purpose of this, so I'm going to hand crimp this. If I don't like the way it's crimped mechanically, then I will actually end up soldering just this center section piece. I want to try and just get that center section piece done. Then what we'll do is we'll slide this grommet will go up in here, and it'll actually get captured by this, the back piece of tongs there, so it'll end up looking like that. So we actually need to go grab our clippers. Okay, so what we got figured out is that my other crimpers don't have it. This one has this little tooth right here, this little spot. I'm going to use that to crimp make the actual electrical connection. Then I'm actually going to use some needle nose to grab the last little piece there. Let me get all that done, and I'm going to show you in detail. This has got to go like this. Let's see. Yeah. All right. I like that. Let me take a picture of that and I'll show you that in detail, and then we're going to start working on the rest of them. Okay, so with special tool number one and special tool number two, we were able to get all of those connected in the way we wanted. Now we're just going to follow our plan. I'll put that on the screen. Let's start with the bottom right is a black ground. Here is our black ground. And we're going to hold this connector like this. And this goes in this bottom. And it's got to go, you got to orientate this, I'm pretty sure, with these little teeth right here up. That's what I'm going to start with. Let's see what that does. Oh, clicked. Perfect. That was just way too easy. So next is my orange. Oh, you hear that clicking? And then my green. Let's make sure we're keeping these. Love it. Then my pink. Oop, click. And then the top right is yellow. It says yellow. Tan. Here's my tan. Oil pressure. And then white. And then purple, fan relay one. And then brown and white. Brown with white tracer. This is my check engine light. Click. Okay. Now to lock those in, we're going to insert this piece. Bill, we may have should have put that other, what you were saying. Then I'm going to put my gasket on there. And then I'm going to use the male side of it to actually get that gasket pushed down in there. That's perfect. So now we're just going to loom this up, and that'll be done. That part will be done. Okay, so how's that look? That's pretty. That cleaned up pretty nice. As my dad used to always say, it's good enough for the girls we go with. So there's the female end, and then here's the male end. And the male end, all we'll have to do is remember, and I've already got it kind of labeled out on this other part of the diagram as to how we're going to wire this guy up, as all those wires come from those instruments. We'll line that back up, and then when we snap that in there, we'll be good to go. So now with that done, we're going to fold that out of the way. We're going to tackle this last little piece. This is all the power source for this entire wire harness. So let's get that all laid out and figured out. Last minute pieces for that, and let's get it tackled. Okay, so to complete this section, we need, first of all, we're going to need what they call a standard blade fuse block. This is, I believe, Dorman. Yeah, Dorman. It's a four position fuse block. It comes with that connector that we're going to need, as well as some other small connectors. Attached to this, we're going to attach these. These are relay sockets. We'll connect those. Those are in the drawing. And then ultimately, we're going to plug in these relays to them. But we're not going to need these till later, so I'm going to throw those over there. So we're going to wire up these connectors to these wires. One thing, when I'm looking at my drawing, the one wire that that kind of dictates a lot of this is the green fuel pump relay wire. It needs to go up to the all the way up to the top where the this relay is. So, and this wire is only this long, so this is going to dictate the rest of them. I'm going to cut all of these other wires off about right in here, and we'll be placing this unit somewhere in here, and that way I don't want to have to extend this green wire, is what I'm trying to avoid. The other thing is, we're not going to cut off this red wire. Is the same as my purple wire on the diagram down in here where the purple wire ended. I didn't have another purple wire, this gauge, so I went ahead and just extended it with this red wire. So this is my starter positive switched wire. So it's just gonna, we're gonna actually pull that out. We're gonna leave that alone. We're gonna mark that as starter wire and just leave that out of this exercise. But we're gonna start dealing with this. So I'm gonna get this tape up, and we're gonna cut all these off about right here. You know what I'll do? These are all about right good. I'm going to go ahead and just mark these, that these are all going to get cut off right here. That way we'll get them all cut off the same length. Things will go together better. Okay, so I double checked. I also didn't want to cut off my black wire because it's got to go up to the bottom of this relay. I've assembled this. This diagram is using the back of the relay, or this fuse block. Here's the front. We're spinning around the back, and I've orientated these right, and I've double checked the pins of the relays to make sure that when I orientate them like this, this is exactly what I want. I need 85 and 86 being on one on top of the other. That's these two outer ones, and the 87 and 80 are left and right. So I went ahead and double checked the, they have numbers on the back of these relays. So this is oriented like the drawing, and this is correct for what I need to do. So I'm going to ready to wire this thing right up. We're going to start off by, since I cut these off, I lost my labels, and before I did that, I marked these, like here's got four little lines on it, so I know I want this one to go to four, fuse four, and I know based on my drawing, fuse four doesn't need anything else, so we're going to strip this back off, and we're going to add one of these connectors, and that piece will be done. Okay. Come. Power Special tool number two. Okay. I'll go ahead and get them. Let me go and get them all trimmed up and then we'll do the rest. Alright, so now I'm ready to put these in here, and this is number four, which is the O2 sensors, the MAF, and the check engine light all come off this number four. And there is an orientation to these. These little wings here go down, and actually it's these wings on the back, they gotta be pointed up. Is that what we said?
Yeah.
So this is gonna go in like this. I'm gonna get it started and then I'm gonna push it in. Snap. Alright, that was number four. Number three. I'm gonna turn that up. Snap. Number two. Okay, now I'm going to bridge this. This has got to go into this. I'm going to just get it here and cut it to length. We'll cut it off right here. And we'll get that. Okay, we got all that in. The next thing I want to do is I'm going to start working on fuse one, which is over here, and I'm going to get the power supply side to it. And the way I drew this, there's going to be a little bit of a problem just to get it physically like this. I want to come out of the top of this fuse, and I've got it so that it basically there's a union, or the they're joined here in this connector to the relay. But you know, that if I just put one of these wires in there, it's going to be a mouthful for it. So I'm not going to be able to put two wires in there. So that's not the way to do it. I'm going to make a jumper. I'm going to actually come off of this supply wire, and I'm going to split it into two different wires. And then from there, I'll put one into this one and one into that one. Let me get that, put it all together, and I'll show you what I did. So it's going to look a little different than this, but the functionality is going to be the same. Okay, so here's where I've got the main power wire, represented by red on the diagram, coming in. Everything's going to exit down here. So while it's drawn up the top up in the diagram, it's really going to, I'm going to have it exit these pieces of this structure. You'll see that in a minute. But anyway, I come in here and I split it, and I went to the top side of the fuse, and also went to the input of the relay. And the metal piece that's in here used to be connected to this piece, and you just got to clip it off. So if you look in the diagram, it's got where it's I've separated one and two, but two, three, and four, I got to keep those jumper together. So I'm not going to clip these apart. This is going to stay together, and that's going to slide down in the top of there. So we're going to move over. Let's see, we've basically done this whole piece here is now done. Let's go to, actually, I want to get this piece right here in. The only thing I need to do is take a pink wire from any one of these positions and run it. I'll go up from this number two, and I need to go up to this side of this relay. So let's get that done next. All right, so here I got this piece put together. That represents that right there. And then this is gonna go into my relay. That snapped in.
that snapped in. Yep. All right, so there's that piece. And now I want to work on, let's finish up this orange piece. It needs a connector on it, and it's going to go into that position. I'll just do this one on camera. I think I got it the right length I want it, so let's just cut it off here. Okay, need a terminal. I like looking down that hole and figure out what orientation this terminal needs to be. It needs to be like this. It's awesome to be ambidextrous. Okay. Okay. Is that all right? While I'm working this direction, I'm gonna go ahead and get my ground in there. I need to run the ground to the bottom side of this relay and then jumper it to the bottom side of this relay. So I'm gonna cut it off and we'll make that little jumper and we'll get that pushed in. Okay, so I made the black wire come up to here with a junction and then came over to another. We're gonna rotate these a little bit and get them. Click there. And click there. All right, so the ground, the relay grounds is now done. Let's get this green wire. Here's my fuel pump relay. This is coming from the PCM. It's what basically turns it, provides power to the relay to tell it to turn the fuel pump on. It needs to go into this top circuit up here. Here's my green. Let me get it trimmed up and a connector on it. All right, got the green connector on. And it needs to go, it's going in this top circuit, and it needs to go actually kind of flipped over. There it did. Okay. I got one last wire, and then I'm done, and it's the wire up here, and that's my, what I got it labeled here on. It was pink going to a keyed source. So I've got pink wire. Let me go grab that and I'll get that last piece on there and we'll be done. All right, so for the pink wire, I grabbed a piece of pink out of what we pulled out of the other harness. I've put an end on it and we're gonna slip it in here. Snap. It's actually come down and go out of the harness over here. And I do have one last wire to run. It's this over here. It's the fuel pump positive feed. I went in and just bought, I got gray here, but I don't have any gray long enough for it. So I went in and just bought some wire, yellow. I'm going to actually change it on the diagram just so it reminds me of what we did. I forgot to close this up. With special tool number two. Okay. That goes here. we'll snap it in here. All right, and it's gonna run down and out over here. So
here are the four. Here are the four wires here. One, this one should have been purple, right? But these four wires, the wires that exit out of the top in the diagram, that's just so it's clear as to how to do it. But realistically, I don't want anything coming out of the top of this thing. When I get this thing mounted, I just want the wires disappearing out of the bottom. So I'm gonna, you can see clearly, I'm gonna take a picture of this. We'll just compare that then with the diagram. That is exactly how we wanted to go. Everything went well. I'm gonna loom this thing up to make it look all nice and get this all tied up, and then this will be done. Let's get that done real quick, and then I'll bring it back. I think we got it done. Here's our accessory piece all loomed up, and here's our fuse block all loomed up. I've got the relays installed, and just like all the other pieces, they want to do a four-wire harness. These are the four wires they're talking about, and here are those four wires. Remember, this red one really is my purple on the diagram. I had to junction it down here from purple to red because that's all I had. So here's my starter. Here's my main power. This goes straight to the battery, and it constant power to the things that need to be constant powers. The pink one goes to the switch, the key switch, for position two on the key switch for your accessories. That turns on the PCM and a lot of these items. It's the whole pink circuit. And then the yellow wire on my diagram is gray. I'm going to change it to yellow just so it matches up. This goes back to the fuel pump. And so based on those four wires, all you need to run the car. These extra wires that are in here are things that are just nice to have. So, okay, so that kind of wraps up the harness. It's kind of all complete. We got everything all buttoned up. I've got two more things I need to do. One is to fill the backside of the PCM connectors. The holes where I de-pin those wires, those holes are still kind of open. They didn't self-close, so I'm going to fill that in with either like a hot glue gun or maybe just a little piece of silicone of some sort. Something that I can take off if I want to. If I want to run some more wires coming out of the, let the computer control more things, I can do that. So I want something that's reversible is a good way of looking at it. The other thing I need to do, and I've got ordered and it comes in about 3 days, is I bought 4 feet. I think I need about 3.5 feet of 1.25 inch loom to go from here all the way up to about right here. Once I do that, then everything's complete. My intention was to end the video here, and then I had to take a couple days off, a couple weeks off of some personal things I needed to take care of. But in doing so, and looking at some other videos, I came up with some other good ideas. I've got a channel that I picked up a couple weeks ago and started following a guy. And he made me think, I mean, I knew kind of what I was wanting to do with my starter cable, but I really didn't have it all planned out. He made me think through all how I need to do that. And I've got some diagrams I've sketched by hand. I'm going to solidify those in a computer system. And I am going to tack one more part on the end of this wiring harness series. And it'll be a diagram and a discussion on how I'm going to handle the starter circuit. I didn't think about it too in depth, but after seeing his video, I thought I needed to take a little deeper look at it, and I've learned a ton of stuff there. So let me get my stuff on paper, and then we'll do a video on that, probably more like a technical talk and that type of thing, just kind of walk you through what I'm doing, and I'll touch base on a few other things that I learned that I won't be doing, but I think it's good to know. So I hope you've enjoyed the series. This has been a lot of fun. I like taking all this stuff apart, putting it back together. The boys have learned a lot. I've learned a lot. If you like mine to do so, please give me a little thumbs up. I think what the thumbs up does, it just helps other viewers that are interested in this type of thing find these videos. So that's really all I'm looking for there. Plus, it just makes me feel good. Other than that, I appreciate everyone watching, all the great comments. What a great community. What a great vehicle to share information. I greatly appreciate everything YouTube does for me. Finally, being a technical guy, finally be able to kind of put my information out there for what it's worth. Anyway, I appreciate you following along. And next, I'm not really quite sure on Project Rowdy what we're going to hit next. I got to buy some parts and... we actually may start taking some things apart and doing a little body work. I'm not sure. So stay tuned and we'll see what comes up next. Until next time. Check it out.